Our second inductee is someone whose stance I've enjoyed for many years, and it's a great pleasure to have Liz Thompson. On behalf of the memory of Ted Shawn, Liz is executive director of the Jacob's Pillow Dance Festival, and she will introduce and present the award to our next guest, Mr. Burton Mumma, former dancer with Ted Shawn's Men Dancers. Liz, if you would come forward, please.
Always my problem. I want to step out of line just for a moment. Those of you who know me know that I do that often. It seems to me that Shawn's contribution to the dance world was twofold. One was entrepreneurial, and one was as an innovator and a radical moving dance in a very new direction. Jacob's Pillow stands as a tribute to his entrepreneurial mind, and Burton Mumma is here today as a tribute to his innovation as a choreographer. And even though the museum is presenting this award to Ted Shawn, I would personally like to share it and present it to Burton Mumma, because without the dancer to realize the choreography doesn't exist. And without the friendship of somebody like Burton Mumma to stand by Ted Shawn would not have been as strong. So I present you, Burton Mumma, to accept this for Ted Shawn.
You get the rose.
I was never a ballerina. I was one of the
I think that we're going to have to share this in spite of all of this generosity, darling.
Okay.
This has to go, of course, to the pillow, which is in great hands and has been ever since Liz has been the director there. I was welcomed open arms when she took command, and she said, "This is your spiritual home and your artistic home, Burton. You are welcome here at any time and for any reason." And I believe that to be true, no matter how long I'm left to live. As some of you will remember, Ted Shawn was very fond of what he termed occasions. And if there was an occasion in the offing, he manufactured one. In the summer of 1965, he decided that Jacob's Pillow and the Ted Shawn Theater should be the scene of the celebration of the Golden Wedding anniversary of Ruth St. Denis and Ted Shawn. Miss Ruth, when advised of this, who had been living apart from Shawn for some years, remarked, "Well, if Teddy wants to make an occasion of it," and when our press representative, Lawrence Humphreys, who's with us today, said that he thought that the media might have a field day with this, and I said, "I think it's a lovely idea, Ted," but he said, "But me no buts, it has been 50 years. We have not been divorced. The new studio is dedicated to Miss Ruth, and Ruthie has appeared here 17 times since 1941. Well, on the spot, Jess Meeker, who's also with us today, was commissioned to write the music for a duet to be composed by Shawn, based on a poem by Ruth entitled "Sitters of the Upper Air." Sitters, I discover, are disembodied beings in the panoply of Hindu gods and goddesses. Invitations were engraved, and a golden medal with their profiles and pertinent dates was struck. And it turned out to be a typically Dennis Shawn production, climaxed by the two of them dressed in oriental splendor as they moved together in their smooth flowing style to a dramatic climax up an incline and disappeared into the upper air. A dancing god and his goddess. Well, of course, the house came down, and press and public alike cheered. And well, they might, for Ruthie was 85 and her Teddy 73. It was Sean's abiding belief that dance, the arts, and humanities are vital to our education, our culture, and our everyday life. And in 1939, John Martin, our Dean of American Dance Critics, in his introduction to dance noted, is in his insistence on this point of view and the zeal of his preaching and promotion of it from one end of this country to the other, that one of his most important contributions lies. I believe that in effect, Sean was an ambassador, a minister of arts to us for all the days of his long life. He died, as we say, full of honors, yet there was one for which he longed, and that was formal recognition by his government. Sean was in no ways dumb. He knew what he had accomplished and what he stood for. And at times he would explode with exclamation points coming from his brow. How long, O Lord, how many administrations must I live through before being invited to that White House? Well, today the spirit of that longing is fulfilled in a most meaningful and most appropriate manner. A national honor comes to him in a typically American gesture from the hands of private citizens of that country he loved and served. It's a most happy occasion for me and a great, great privilege to stand in a house of dance, this milestone of American culture, and to share in accepting an award in the name, honor, and memory of Ted Sean.